All right, welcome back, everybody. As promised, we're here with the University of Hawaii geologist, who actually is a volcanologist because Scott Rowland specializes in volcanoes. Little known fact, we went over on a trip together about 15 years ago, hiked down, watched lava flow into the sea. This is a much different event. I want to go back about 26 hours ago when scientists were mixed on whether or not there would be an eruptive event. So what were your thoughts? And now, in retrospect, are you surprised?
Certainly, when the earthquakes, the multitude of very shallow earthquakes in Leilani Estates, and especially once the ground started to crack, it was pretty clear that magma was near the surface and passing underground there. Whether it would erupt there or continue on down rift, I don't think anyone really knew. It did seem to stall there. The earthquakes seemed to stall there. So I'm not surprised that it did erupt. I certainly couldn't have predicted exactly where or when, and I don't think anyone could have.
And even though you've dedicated your adult life to studying volcanoes, even looking forward, there's really no direct science that could allow you to put your finger on it and say, this is going to happen or that's going to happen, true?
That's correct. That's correct. And we can definitely know in general what kinds of things are going to happen. The earthquakes tell us that magma is moving underground, and when those earthquakes localize, then that gives you a sense that probably this is the most likely place. And certainly when the ground cracks occur, that means the ground's being pushed apart for something under there. But again, the details of exactly when or where we don't have the ability to do that.
Okay, I want to talk to one of the byproducts, of course, is all the carbon monoxide, the sulfur dioxide, all the fumes that are coming, some of these fumes being very dangerous. In fact, roads shut down today, not because of lava, but because of the potentially hazardous fumes. How hazardous are they, and what do people need to understand?
The gas that people are worried about is sulfur dioxide. There's not really carbon monoxide, but sulfur dioxide, which is the same thing that produces VOG. So everybody's familiar with VOG.
Right.
When you see VOG, it's not high concentrations of sulfur dioxide. It's a low concentration that's mixed with the atmosphere somewhat. If you're close to a source, such as Pu'uo'o itself or Halemaumau, or in this case, these eruptive vents, the concentration of sulfur dioxide is considerably higher. And it's not something that you can breathe in high concentrations. It's irritating in lower concentrations. But if it's really high concentration, it's dangerous for anybody, whether you've got compromised lungs or not.
Okay. In a word, do you think this is going to last longer than a few days?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. And beyond that, no sense asking because, like you said, nobody knows.
That's right.
All right. Scott Rowland, University of Hawaii geologist, volcanologist. Very cool. This is what you live for, you were saying.
That is correct.
Very exciting time. Okay, thank you very much. We'll have more after the break. We're going to go back live to the Big Island, check in with Marissa Yamani once again on the latest from that side.